How are you doing? Good to see you.
Doing good, bro.
So much going on. Your gym is like a beehive. It's great to see.
A lot of fights, man.
What do you tell me many years ago? If you build it, they will come. Okay.
They will come.
Ray Murataya against Devin Haney for all the belts. What do you think if that fight's next?
Devin Haney won't fight Ray Murataya.
What if he would? What if they did fight?
He won't.
They fought on amateurs.
Yeah, but he won. That's why. That's why he won't.
Ray, he wouldn't fight you? You think Devin would prefer not to fight you, fight anyone else?
Devin won't fight Ray.
I hope he fights him, but if they did fight, what would happen?
It's a good fight, man. Devin Haney's a great fighter, man. He's undisputed champion, so we got to... But you know, I'm not saying he won't fight him because Devin's a warrior, man. He's not because he's a warrior. It's just that it's too much in you know, too much risk, like for like I would say for the type of fights that Devin Haney wants already. You know, Devin Haney is undisputed champion, so he wants, you know, the Shakurs, the...
He doesn't want Shakur. Well, 125%, no. Robert. That doesn't mean you want the fight.
Well, Shakur's, right? That's also something.
He's a two-division champion. Respect him.
But that guy's a champion, so Shakur should also consider it because it's a big fight for him, too. And if he wants to become a disputed, that's the way it is. That is like a lot of fighters, you know, like, what's his name? Who was complaining about how much percentage they pay for the sanctioning bodies?
Spence.
Okay. Well, of course, those sanctioning bodies are the ones that make you worth the value that he is. If it wasn't for those belts, he wouldn't be fighting for the undisputed champion against Crawford. The fight wouldn't be worth as much if it wasn't for the undisputed.
Well, he wanted to know where the money's used. That's what he wanted.
Does he have, you know, like I'm saying, I don't have my fighters asking me where the money goes. Where does, you know what I mean? That's the WBC, the IBF. That's their. They have a lot. They have offices to pay. They have people. They have hundreds of people running around the world. You know, going to all the fights, they pay for all that. So I don't think it's right to once you become champion, you become making millions and millions. At first, you had no problem winning that title when you wanted to become champion. But now that you're champion and you're gonna fight for the undisputed, and you know it's 3%, now it's a lot to pay. Well, you know, that's just the way it is.
Okay, so let me ask you this: Spence and Crawford were less worth 12 days away.
Yes.
How do you see the fight unfolding, Robert? You face both
fight.
Of them.
Sick as fight, man. I'm telling you, I can't. I always say Crawford, but honestly, I don't know why. You know, it's not like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just that close of a fight.
I say Spence, but I know him better, you know? So.
Well, yeah.
And he has a resume, and he has 3 belts, and it's a good fight. It's a very close fight.
It's such a close
you
fight
respect
that,
both
that
fighters.
It's hard to pick. It's hard to really pick a winner, you know, because it's hard, man. It could go either way. Anybody.
So you
could
wouldn't
win.
Bet on this one. You wouldn't tell me don't bet.
No, I wouldn't, man. Because if I say I'm gonna bet on Crawford and then Spence could beat him, you know, I would. I don't bet anyways. But I wouldn't bet it. I wouldn't bet on this one because this one's so fucking close. Where well, it's a 50-50. Well, actually, it's not a bad bet because you have 50% chance of winning.
So bet the same on each one.
Yeah. So
but let me ask you this, Robert. I know you faced Spence with Mikey. Did you ever face Crawford in the
Not in the pros.
Okay.
Not in the pros.
Because I wanted to ask which one's harder to prepare for. They're both great.
They're both great, bro. It's tough, man. The thing is that they're both... That's why it's such a fucking good fight, man. Big-ass fight. Good-ass fight. Good-ass fight.
So, back to... What you think 25-75 okay. is fair?
Look,
to make a fight?
When you want to... When you... Look, like if you know, just... In my example, Remy,
yeah.
They ask us, we're looking for the title. We're looking for the title. I don't, I'm not mentioning any champion, but we're looking for the title. And then the champion gives us an opportunity. I don't give a fuck what fucking percentage they give me. I want to become champion. You know, when Josh, when they called us for Josh's fight against Maloney the first time, fuck, we wanted that fucking opportunity. So we're like, fuck it, you know, let's do it for that kind of money. You know what I mean? We want that opportunity, and we have no problem. And then we want that opportunity, so we have no problem paying that 3% to the WBA because we want to become champions. But now when you're making 10, 20 million, now you're complaining about that 3%, you shouldn't be complaining because you're not complaining about your trainer making that 10% because he earned it, he deserves it. I think the sanctioning bodies deserve it too because they make you what you are. They make you that champion. They make you worth more money.
Yeah.
That's the way I see it, bro, honestly. It's like, you know, When fighters start making millions and millions of dollars, they try to cut the trainer's percentage down.
Always.
Why do they do that when they should give them a raise?
That's a good question.
They should give him a raise.
I agree.
They should give him a fucking raise, you know.
I agree, Robert.
Because they made it that far. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They should.
But they don't do that.
They don't do it. They want to pay him less.
I've heard every coach get a pay cut the more the fighter makes.
Right?
Which is messed up.
Why do they do that? Why don't they give him a raise, a little bonus every fucking fight?
They should.
Because they did it together, because they're where they're at because of the trainer, too.
So what do you think about Tim Bradley saying no dads in a corner?
Well, I think that's a big mistake. I think there is some dads that might be problem.
But there could be coaches that are problem.
But not exactly. Same thing with coaches that are problem. Some coaches are really bad and, you know, they fucking go take their fighters to get killed. You know, there's coaches that are really bad. That. They don't have to be that
bad. I don't want to say names, but
I think Bradley's, you know, that's a bad comment by Bradley.
Because then your dad wouldn't be there. Yeah,
exactly,
he was messed up.
Exactly. Look at Trinidad's dad. Look at Mosley's dad. Look at everything they did.
Lomachenko.
Yeah, Lomachenko's dad.
Years in the
amateur. Yeah, that's the wrong.
Just because he has beef with Tio, he said.
Yeah, that's the wrong thing to do. And there is those fighters where the dad might be a problem. Yes. But
not Tio's dad. They're one, two divisions.
Look at what they've done. Exactly. But you know, I think Timothy Bradley, you know, didn't really think of the whole picture the way it is, because there is coaches that are, they just don't have to be dads. They're just not good for boxing.
Yeah, I agree. So.